reaping. Do you have abroad?
No.
Whose family do you have abroad?
No.
Whose family do you have abroad?
No.
It's not your enemy.
Bring your anointing water. Bring your anointing. Forget about it. Don't tell me anything, please. Don't upset the Holy Spirit. What is it?
Abroad. Mommy, don't talk for her. Don't talk for her. Go and give her back and let her water. Thank you, Jesus, for healing her. 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 Thank you, Jesus.
You demon
of deafness, come out of her!
Your mouth. Out!
Shut up! Who do you have abroad? Who do you have abroad? Who do you have abroad? The 2 years having problems. A fine lady like this. Be healed in the mighty name of Jesus. Be healed in the mighty name of Jesus. I command your ear to open. Mighty name of Jesus. Mighty name of Jesus. Mighty name of Jesus. Mighty name of Jesus. Mighty name of Jesus Christ. Be healed. Be healed. Be healed. Be healed. Be healed. Mighty name of Jesus Christ. Who do you have abroad? Our faith is 32/100 because of her beauty. That's why I'm just praying for her with anger. You know why? She has gone to so many places. She has gone to, that's why I'm saying for her. She has gone to so many places and she has lost her faith.
not our fault. We have gone to many places.
You have gone to many places.
Many places.
Many places.
Nowhere I have never gone.
Nowhere you have not gone to. And she has spent a lot of money.
That's why you tell me last Sunday I should call her. She went to Lagos. Then I have to call her and say, we want to see her.
Why is it about Jesus? Why is it about Jesus? Be healed! Be healed! Be healed! Be healed! Be healed! I command your ears to hear for my spirit. Hey!
Hey!
Hey! What is your name? What is your name?
Open.
Crying. She has gone to so many places. I have told you, somebody come and marry you from France is not a miracle. This is a miracle. This is a... Did I prophesy to her? What are you looking for? Solution. Say solution. Who did you have abroad?
Oh.
That is, which sister do you have abroad? Sat. That is her name. God is good. Okay, cannot talk, cannot hear. He cannot talk, he cannot hear, but now he's talking. And now he's hearing. Oh. What are you? Are you just looking like that? Doing like this, we are worshiping God. demonstration of man.
You will say, oh, what is this man doing? We are worshiping God. It's God we are worshiping. You see, when you are in this kind of a church, you don't look at your time. Because you too, you are here for something. So you should say, oh God, open my file. I love this lady. No, he said, open my file. And prophecy came to her. Prophecy came. And God, mommy, are you happy?
I'm happy, daddy.
You have gone to so many places.
Uncountable.
Uncountable. You know, I told you, I said, God told us that me and TB Joshua have the same gift. I'm very sure you are not getting to TB Joshua's place.
She went to herself.
She went herself.
She went herself. Then TB Joshua called me. He said, I should come and tell her how all this thing happened to her. Then that time, I was not feeling fine. I didn't went.
You didn't went?
I didn't went. Even yesterday, sir, when I was talking to you, I have a call. Then I answered the call. He said it's from Manuel TV. Because Joshua is going to do a birthday.
Okay.
And when I want to answer them, this thing cut off. I said, okay, when I come here today, I will tell you.
Mama, so, you know, Mommy, don't cry. Don't cry. You see, I have told you, the first day you met me, I said, this is your church. I have told you this is your church. You know, the problem some of you have is your pastor. You are too familiar with your pastor. Okay? But our logo is that if your church does not change you, change your church. I don't expect to see this kind of crowd when Omokoji is in town. I don't expect to see. I expect the crowd to move from here to that house. Yes, I have told you the first time me and you met, I said, this is your church. But you say, I'm the mother of sugar. I'm the mother of honey. In so-so place. Have you seen that God is in me?
Everything you tell me, I believe. And I've been working towards it. I told you that she went to Lagos. You said, call her for me. Then I went and tell my second son to go and bring her. And that is why she's here today.
God is in our midst. God is in our midst. Next week Sunday, if you know you want to marry, you want to carry your baby, please make sure you are here. This kind of miracle will happen to you. Amen. That is what we're going to be doing from now to December. Those who want to build house, who want to buy their car and go to and build house and buy a car next upper Sunday. Those who want to travel, just like that. I have told you, God has added more power to me. Amen. To my power. Open your mouth. Open your mouth. How many says not here? Is this free? Just once. If you have faith, you can't receive this bread. Can you talk here now? What is your name?
Opal.
We must talk. We are particularizing the scripture. The deaf hear, the dumb talk, the lame walk, the dead rise. Blind see. 7 years of blindness. So, it's coming to testify before the end of this month. That somebody come and marry you from France, it's not a testimony. Multiple fibroid that was booked to be operated. We say in the name of our God, we stand against it. You're going to get belly. And by December, we speak. And now, scan came out. The lady is pregnant. Powerful. Power.
Thank you, Jesus, for healing her.
aid.
Ear aid.
Yes.
Without this, cannot hear anything.
He can't hear anything.
And she can't talk.
She can't talk. But when he plays this,
you have seen today by yourself. Nobody came and tell you. You have seen what God is doing in this church. The deaf is hearing. He's talking. Come here. Say it. Fine. Fine. You are sound. And you are fine. Clap for Jesus Christ. Mommy, are you happy? You are happy.
Happy. I'm happy. That this is, I come here, trial from right to left. That's why I don't want to give testimony yet. Not that I don't have testimony to give.
Okay, since you have come here, you have a testimony.
I have testimony, but the trial from right and left. I just, yesterday this hand was paining me. I don't fall, I don't do anything. I wake up this morning, I can't walk with my hand. See my hand?
It just swell up.
I can't use it to do anything.
Mommy, do you know your challenge? You know your challenge?
Yes.
The challenge of these people is Olokun. Olokun from your mother's side, and then that idol spirit from your father's side.
Yes.
They are the one who are managing their life. And you know what he's telling you? He said, until you come back and bow to me, you'll be facing challenges.
I have already bowed.
You bow to Jesus, not to him. No, I'm not saying me, mommy. You bow to Jesus. Oh, bow to Jesus. Nobody should bow to a man of God. If you thank me, if anybody thank me, you are telling me I'm stupid. Only, and thou Lord God Almighty, worthy to receive all thanks, power, glory, honor, and worship. I am God. I will not share my glory with anybody. Neither will I give my praise to any man. Don't praise any man. Praise Jesus. If you praise me, you are saying I am stupid. I am talking number one original.
Okay, original.
It is us who call ourselves donkey. Donkey is an animal. For you to say, man of God, say it's a donkey of Jesus, you should know the level we have with Jesus Christ. Where is Mama? Where you are making call? Where are you going? Come here. Follow me. Follow me.
Since 2011, I discovered
go and raise this thing so that we can hear where.
I discovered that I had a fibroid. Ever since, I've been having heavy flow. At times, I see my period twice a month or to rush like 2 weeks or 8 days, 9 days. Even on the first this year, the period started. The first Sunday of this year, I couldn't go to church because of the period. He rushed for almost 1 week. If I'm under my period, I don't come out because it will surely disgrace me. Even though I change my pad now, I do wear up to 3 pads at a time. But since I start coming to this church, I started 4 weeks ago. And my period, I don't even care when it comes. It can come at any time. But since last month, the thing regulated. I was supposed to be seeing my period every 28 days. That is the normal days of same period. And the thing started on the 19th of, that is on 29th of last month, which on the 1st of January I saw. That is 28 days. And I saw my period just 4 days.
4 days, and you are waiting like that. Can somebody shout hallelujah?
Hallelujah!
From 14 days of heavy flow to 4 days of normal menstruation. You can see God can do all things. It's just for you to believe. Once you believe, you will receive. God bless you, my sister. Continue.
Then on Sunday, I came to church. I only wore one pad. On Monday, I have work. I said, how can I do this work without many pads? And I work, nothing stain me. And then after that, on the 29th, somebody invited me to their church. When I got there, it's not what I expected that I saw. I said, okay, my house is very far. I can't go back. God, I don't want this man to see anything about me. And anything they are doing in this church, I won't participate. But when they break, my leg started swelling for 2 weeks. On Thursday, I didn't even remember. When the prophet was asking me, do you have any testimony? I said, no. But when I went to see that, I checked my leg. Everything just disappeared.
Power! I just talked to you alone. And the swollen leg just disappeared.
Yes, sir. Then,
Jesus is good.
As I was coming to church that on Thursday, I said, God, because a friend brought me to this church. I told her my challenges. She asked me, have you told the prophet? I said, no. But he put me on program. I said, I should go and tell him. As I was coming in the morning, I said, God, just open my page to your servant. Open his eyes to see me. And immediately I came out that day. My case was open. And ever since he prayed on water and gave it to me, I have been using it. Then I use it to bait. My dream life have changed. And when I'm sleeping at night, it's like I'm being bit, purified. When I wake up sound and healthy. Even last night, I dreamed that somebody just come to me and gave me money and said, I'm sorry, just walk away. When I woke up, I thank God. Praise the Lord.
She wants to sing first.
Mama, let me help you hold on.
Wow, where say over here?
Leave her for her.
Wow, where say?
Leave it for her.
Thank you, everybody. Thank you.
Okay, more than 15 years now. Ni kesi mami.
Oh, she has been sick for about 15 years more.
Mama, put down for your mouth. Make we hear you.
There
was no medication she did not take.
You were straight away. Ya ohunwe or eko ekpe ya abalo mi.
Mommy, let her assist you so that we can hear what you are saying. Let her assist you like this. Hold it for her. Hold it for mommy. Hold it for her.
She did x-ray. All the investigations she did, but all her body was still paining her.
Oko ni no reba ina do tama ina we gbe ni condition me je ina we ze dukun iri me go ina we gbe wo me.
There's a woman there, she said. She told the woman all her problems.
Where is the woman? Let's clap for the fattest woman in Christ Supreme.
In a way, on our way, you have your church here. In a way, you on our way this Sunday, in a way this Sunday, rugby. No, la, no, give my day, then Wednesday.
Then this woman asked her if she will go to church. Then she now said, what date? Or the woman asked her, what she said she will go on Sunday. Oh, no, on Sunday, she said Sunday was too far. Maybe the woman brought her earlier than that Sunday. They came here.
I say, mana.
When they got here,
oh, you were lehun me.
The man of God prayed.
Ona lehun, ya me ina wa
ngun. He prayed into the water and she drank it.
Ove ni megi bi ebi gi so wa.
She slept like she has never slept before.
Are you just looking like that?
How about 15 years of suffering? was suffering.
Her whole body was light after drinking that water.
Power.
He
said,
He's
asking you to pray to, for our Father so that he can have more anointing to help all of us.
I want to ask something. When mommy was coming here, he asked the person that brought her how much we will collect. Answer.
Then she asked that our friend, how much does he charge? The woman said, she doesn't take any money. Is there anything like that? Is there any pastor that will pray for you and will not take something from you? Because of this, the disability of all the.
This is Jesus.
Because the sickness had made her to be so weak, she was unable to do many things. But now she does everything. She goes to the market, she says everything is okay in her life.
This is good news.
Power.
This is good news. Good news is to wipe away our tears. I have been telling you, your challenge is my challenge.
Yes, sir.
No, how many car did I have? If you are poor, I am poor. No matter how strong I am, if you are sick, I am sick. This is good news.
Amen.
Go and announce to them that Omo Koje Sinta,
Donkey Original, do something.
Doctor Zawa. He said, you and TB Joshua have the same gift.
Yes, sir.
It's in synagogue they turn SS to Hehe. It's in synagogue they turn HIV to negative.
Yes, sir.
And that is what is happening here. 15 years of suffering come to a hand when Jesus met her. Jesus will meet you today.
Amen.
Please go and be our evangelist. Go to far and sundry and tell them that Jesus has visited Benin City. Upper Mission. You know why we started in Upper Mission? Our mission is upper than any other mission yet.
Yes, sir.
That's why we started. Power.
Christ Supreme Ministry.
My name is Faith.
Yes, sir, Mama. Mama.
So I come here on Thursday.
Yes.
To see my message is a hard for me.
You know they see our message.
I know they see him.
Yes.
Come out, you go to disturb me. They inch me. Go to work out all over my body.
Yes.
And recently I enter here. So God just talk, just touch man of God. Just hit me for belly. Say before on Sunday, today, so I go see my message.
What is today?
Before I from here go, the thing don't they come out.
What is today? What is today?
On Sunday.
What is that?
Power.
Christ Supreme Ministry.
Power.
We have to give menstruation. We have to give. People are going to TB Joshua Church because of menstruation cysts. And God bless you. You have to testify. People are coming from abroad to synagogue.
Power. Christ Supreme Ministry.
Please don't mind my voice. I have a broken voice because
He has some cough or so.
I just recovered from fever. Anyway, my testimony goes like this. I started with the commission early December. It was my cousin that dragged me down to this place. Before then, I was angry. Why? Because the guy has never one day attended church. Why would he invite me to a church? I was just angry with him myself. The other man of God, I think the man is called John. He also
what he's saying is that the person who invited him here has not been going to church. So he was angry with him. Say, this man, you are not going to church. Why will you now come and invite me to another church? You are not going to church. That is what he's saying because of his voice.
So all the same, I overlook it. So it was December, early December, when I got to his house. I think he was going to church. I said, okay, are you going to church? You should wait for me. Let me get ready. So I escorted him down to this place. I was sitting in front of the congregation here. So the man of God, when he was preaching, he went straight to me and called me. He said he fell in love with my tie because I was putting on a suit. When the man was admiring the tie, he said, can he speak to me? I said, yes, man of God, you can speak to me. He said, the tie I'm putting on is like they tie me with that rope. Like I can't move forward. Like if I'm going forward, the rope, they use it to draw me back. So he now caught the tie.
Praise God. Praise God. Let me not bother you so much. You see, this my son came here, and who remember the day that he was putting on suit? We asked somebody to cut the tie away. Whatever we ask you to do, please do it by faith. You know, his wife is abroad. And you know, if woman stay 1 year, 2 years, and the husband could not join her, that woman might be tempted to have another boyfriend. So there was a lot of worry. And he has been trying to go and meet his wife. He tried, it couldn't be possible until he joined us by December. You know, when he joined us by December, I prophesied to him because I saw he was tied here. His wife is abroad, but he was tied down here. So, and he was putting on black tie. And it was a black rope they used to tie him down here. So, that was what we cut away. He couldn't be he was happy. Because how can you bring a tie? You dress with a coat. And you came to the church. A church, the pastor you don't know before, say you should remove your tie, I want to cut it. If you are not careful, you might slap the pastor. Because he has a pastor before he came here. But by the grace of God, he listened to that man that was not going to church. Because the man that was not going to church came here and received breakthrough. And he said, oh, I don't believe in church before, but I believe this God, there is God here. So went and tell this man because he knows this man is going through serious rope bondage. So we caught it. Since that time till now, on Tuesday, you will see him in the church. On Saturday, you will see him in the church. On Thursday, you will see him in the church. On Sunday, you will see him in the church. Because there is something me and him we are pursuing. And what are we pursuing is that he must go and meet his wife abroad. That's what we are pursuing. He came here and joined us by December.
Hey, when I came, I did not disclose anything with the pastor that I'm processing a visa. But I wanted him to see it himself. So I think before I got to this church, I have attended, I've submitted myself to the embassy 6 times. They turned me back. They have not disclosed everything to him that.
I just want to cut it short. Okay? Because of your voice. Later, he disclosed to me about visa and others. He has, according to him, you had him 6 times he has tried. They dismissed him 6 good times. So, since that time, me and him have been pursuing that thing. Since 2 months now, we pursue that together to make sure that he has to go back and meet his wife. I just want to cut this short because by next week, we have a lot of prayer. Now, I want to meet my partners today. That's why I'm cutting this short. So, eventually, what I'm trying to say is that once he joined this church 2 months ago, there is no service he will not attend. And there is no time I will not lay hand upon him and do deliverance for him. In this church, no one day I lay hand upon him that he will not fall down. As he's falling down, God was purging him off of all the BTS and all the STD and BTD. Those are background demon that put rope in his neck and on the rest and them. But the same background demon took one of his documents away when he went and submit. And the thing was missing, what he submitted by himself. And that thing was very important. He kept on coming here, I said, don't worry, we'll find it. God will find it. I kept on doing deliverance for him. Why I'm saying is that some of you, I pray for you today now. Next Sunday, we will not see you. You will not follow your miracle. You will still go back to where you are. You will say, ping here today, ping tomorrow, ping next tomorrow, ping next tomorrow. After 3 months, you come back again. But this man, I'm on the altar, I want to vouch for him. Since he joined me early December till now, he has never attended any other church. Because 6 times, he has attempted to travel and they failed him. But by the grace of God, what he has missed for 2 months, within two, what has missed for 6 times, within 2 months, where is the visa now?
It's somewhere.
It's somewhere. You kept it somewhere.
I brought it.
You brought it on Tuesday. Is he here with you?
Yes, sir.
Okay. He has kept it. He has came and showed me the visa on Thursday. By the grace of God now.
Give me 1 year visa.
Okay. They have given him visa now. By the grace of God, anytime from now, he will go and meet his wife. That is what we are praying for. Okay? Because we do not want marriage to be broken, to be separated. Within 2 months of just being here, consistent and faith, come out for deliverance all the time. What he has missed 6 times, once in this church, he has gotten it. Now, today, tomorrow, or next tomorrow, anytime you might not see him here again, he will disappear and go and meet his wife. So, I'm going to end this testimony of today in this place because of time. Next week, we have a lot of prayer. I just want to touch one or two people so that we can close. I have partners meeting.
Christ Supreme Ministry International. Power. Praise God. My name is Faith Izeko. I was here on Thursday to see that the after prayer. I was having stomach pain and abdominal pain. So when I went for test, they said the stomach pain is ulcer. When I came here on Thursday, after prayer, God healed me completely. And today I'm free.
What of the thing that is going around in your chest?
It's like worm. It's normally walk on in my chest. After prayer, daddy, I cannot find
it. Now you didn't see it?
No, sir.
It's not a worm. Are you still feeling it?
No, sir.
The ulcer, are you still feeling it? No, sir. The thing walking your chest has gone. Usher has gone, low abdomen, 3 things at the same time. Let's land for Jesus. Did your husband know that you are ill now?
I didn't tell him.
He didn't tell your husband. He just see your face beautiful. You have to bring your husband to know me. He needs power. Your husband is a pastor. Is that not so? A real pastor, but pastor, past pastor. Okay? So, he has to come so that I will lay hand upon him, so that power will follow him. You can see, you have all these 3 challenges. He couldn't, he just insulting you. You don't have faith, you don't have faith, you don't have faith. He has no gift of healing. It's not, how many people in your church has he prayed for? And how many people has come and testified for HIV in your church? How many people? If you cannot pray for HIV to disappear, how will the ulcer disappear? Pastor, past pastor. End of state. Power.
Power.
Christ Supreme Ministry.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
I want to testify what God has done for me in this church. 4 or 5 years ago, I was sick. Hypertension. All my mother's, my grandmother's children, no one passed 60 years of age. When I'm able to reach 60, I will be praying. I started fasting by force. This my chest, it be like saying a stone, then put, since 5 years ago. Sometimes I will be inside, with my children almost about 3 weeks. Fear will not allow me to tell my people, say, I'm sick. I say, my God, they talk all the time. Sometimes I go to the hospital. Sometimes they admit me. So it becomes a shame for me. At any time I'm sick, I will not tell anybody again. One day, that fateful day, my last mother born, I was sick almost 3 weeks. I'm in my lying bed. I cannot go to hospital. My sister phoned me here. Say, Mommy, how are you? I say, I'm not well. I better not tell anybody. Say, I'm the sick. I say, since 2 weeks now, I've been inside. You just says, I say, no, not fit to go market. He say, make I just come. One church when you see near their place here for upper mission, what has? I say, I dey pray God, make he release me small. If he release me, I go come. God be the glory, 1 week pass. The other week, one Saturday, I say, I must go to church today. The thing when I dey say, abandoned, one man just come in the morning. Say, you dey say this thing again? I say, yes. He say, give me, I want to buy. He just buy him. I just see my transport. I see the money when I go use from Welu to upper mission. I say, praise the Lord. I tell my daughter, bath, make we go. Now, so we reach here. When I reach here, I say, I don't heal you. I don't heal in Jesus' name. My mind was here because I don't work out. I don't pray. I don't fast. Nothing when I never do. I was born as a Christian. Brought up as a Christian. Married as a Christian home. But I never see things like this. So, power package ministry. Praise the Lord. So now I come here. So now the pastor just carry me out. He said, Mommy, say where your problem is coming far. He said, it's very far. I wonder. Say where my grandmother? I said, my grandmother, I know him as a dede. But I know my mother. My mother has no juju. My father has no juju. He said, your grandmother. He said, your problem is come from your grandmother. As he just they say, everything are true. He can't say one thing which I like most. He said, my mother died by accident at the age of 60 years. He said, yes. Two of my mother was a graduate. One graduated at Ibadan. One graduated at Lagos. But my mother did not ask him to eat the fruit of his labor. I said, yes, they see the problem you are facing. It's now it's your turn. Say, make I tell God, say, as I be pray, as I be fast, I know God. Now you stay alive. So the man prayed me, I was saying, God, make I not say make I try because I don't work. Before I reach house, this my chest might be like load. He can't release me. He can't release me. The sleep when I never sleep before. I reach out, I bath, I sleep. The thing where God just do me most. As I reach, so I not to see nobody to favor me. Nobody, no favor. They go say I get, my brother I get. Nobody can even give me 1 hour. But by God's glory, as I just stepped here, to the gate, one of my sisters just gave me 2,000 naira. Ah! Praise the Lord. Hey, I say, Baba, I go eat today. I say, I don't heal. By God's grace, I don't heal. I don't take this money to buy mercy. So I took that money. When I reach into Benin, I buy things when I go eat. Since then, I'll be healed.
Power.
Hallelujah. Now I say, make I tell God do. Because that favor is before 2 or 3 days. My daughter in Lagos is for me. Mommy, I sent you some money. Yeah. I said, God, you do well, though. 3 days of it. He sent my last born. Say, make it your bad provision. Ghana must go full. He carry out to Yare. Say, make a dropper for me. Make a day eat. Many things when I never enjoyed before, it has started. I beg, make my help me that man of God.
Prayer ministry.
Power.
Power.
Thanks to prayer ministry.
My name is Mrs. Gloria Ogie.
I'm here to thank God for my life, for what God has done in my life.
Before Madam continue, let's show us why I was praying for her. Let's show you why I was praying for her. That will let you know that you must come and testify. Please start it from beginning. Start it from beginning. Okay. Can you hold it, madam? Can you hold it? Do you know you are removing your chain?
No, sir.
You don't know. You can't know. Do you know you removed your wedding ring?
No, sir.
If anybody say remove my wedding ring, what do you call the person? I'm robber. Yes. Do you know when you are removing your wedding ring?
No, sir.
Do you know when you remove this one?
No, sir.
This one is 500 naira. They bought it. Ask her. 500 naira. They couldn't help her. When you see a good place, you will not like the place. It's Satan. It's Satan. This thing, 500 naira, he bought it. How much did you bought it?
500 naira.
500 naira. He didn't help her. But he was here. He did not buy anything. And then, your testimony now.
My name is Mrs. Gloria Oki. For the past a year and some months now, I've been very sick, seriously sick. I cannot stand like this. I'll just be losing strength. I've been seeing myself eating the dream, seeing people collecting money from me. Gradually, my business, everything came down. I was selling clothes, selling jewelry. I even packed. I was not doing anything again. Then sickness started. I will be very sick. When I go to the hospital, they will say it's typhoid. I will run the test. They will say it's typhoid 160. After I finish treating this test, they will treat me. After 2 weeks, I go back again. The same typhoid 160. I was just walking, running from going to hospital to hospital. I was tired. Many people tell me to go to native drugs. Anything they will ask me to do, I will be drinking everything. I was tired. In the night, I will not sleep. I will not be able to sleep. My heart will not be breathing well. I will just manage to sleep. If they break self, I'll say, God, so I'm still alive. I will just be surprised to see myself alive because I know what I'm passing through. So my color changed. I used to be very, very fair, fat and beautiful. My color changed. I was getting smaller and smaller. I said, God, I don't know what, I was tired. I was telling my husband I'm tired. I don't even know what is wrong with me again. Everybody around me were even tired. There was a day I was about to give up. December 20, 21, 22 to 25th. I did not know whether they did Christmas myself. My neighbor tried for me, if not for them. I almost give up. So that was that. I was just managing myself. Then a woman came. There was a woman near my house. One day, I was inside. She just came. Say, who's inside? I said, come inside. She said, oh, I wish I know you were at home. There is a church that they just opened newly in this White House. I said, hey, why are you not going to call me? I said, any church now will go. He said, I wish I know. I would have come and call you. I said, where is the church? Can I still meet the pastor? Say, no, maybe they would have closed now. They might have closed. So okay, when are they going to hold another program? Say, I should come on Saturday. So okay. That very Saturday, I woke up very early. I got ready. You ma'am carry me to this place. When I came here, I was just sitting down. The man of God was praying for another person. He just got to my place and bring me out and was praying for me. I did not see him before. I've not talked to him. I was even surprised. He prayed and delivered me. I went and sat down. Then that was how I was coming. He prayed for me, prayed for me, prayed for me. Then it came to a time that the drugs I went to collect in the hospital, I even took overdose because they wanted to kill me by all means. In the dream, I will see myself put my hands around this electric to be shocking me, but I will not die. Somebody will come and shoot me, but I will not die. The last time I took overdose, and that drug is very strong, antibiotics. But I was afraid, say God. So that was why the man of God was praying for me. Till yesterday, he did serious deliverance for me. before I sleep, there was a time I called him the night. I could not breathe again. That time, I came here on Saturday. In the night of that Saturday, they wanted to kill me. I was just seeing myself. I was going. I said, what am I going to do? My husband was afraid. I said, what am I going to do? One man said, call the man of God. And I called him. I said, God, this time, around after 11, hey, I want to disturb this man. But one man said, call him. I called him. He prayed for me. He said, I should place him on my chest. He said, I should carry pure water. He prayed for me very well. Then after... my breathing just rise up. I was happy. I said, God, thank you. So that was how I came here yesterday. He did deliverance for me. And yesterday night, I slept as I've never slept before. That's why I said,
hallelujah! Can somebody shout hallelujah?
Hallelujah!
Can somebody shout hallelujah?
Hallelujah!
Praise the Lord.
So now, you are okay now.
Yes, sir.
You can do what you can't do before.
Yes, sir.
It shows in your body. Your yellow has come back.
Amen.
You can see her color when I was praying for her. It was the evil spirit that make her body to be green. As if it's, bleaching. She's a fair woman. As you can see her now, since yesterday, her color has changed. When I was praying for her, you see, this thing was in her hand. You see the way he removed it. If this one were to be of God, there's no way he was able to remove it and throw it away. Because they bought it for 500 naira. This is where your people, some of you like to go. After today, now when I pray for you, tomorrow you are here, you still go back to now your church. Where they sell this kind of thing for you for 500 naira. Even if you want to have it, 500 naira is too much to sell it. But it doesn't work. What can Satan, what can darkness got to do with light? If this is light, and she's putting it in her hand, I don't think she will need another deliverance. So that is why you must come and testify. She was tired of life. She was about to die. She even took overdose. And she was about to die. And now, when you come, did we collect any money from you?
No, sir.
Did we ask you to buy anything before we pray for you?
No, sir.
Freely you receive, freely you give, but you must come and testify. Don't testify and run away, because this your testimony is not forever. Stay in the church and testify the more. In Lagos, there's one particular woman, Mama Yonacho, Abi. She testifies every week. All the millions she's paying, she's going bank. Has she paid? Has she not paid? She has paid then. So, testimony is for your own good, not for my own good. So don't give testimony and say, oh, because people have seen me, they pray for me. Every one of us have challenges. Me, myself, I have a challenge. My challenge now, I need money to be on the air. My challenge, see my listening and stuff finish. So everybody needs challenge. But our challenge is different from each other. So nobody will make mockery of you because you are giving one kind of testimony or not. Anybody who make mockery of you and laugh at you, that person has cursed himself. Yes, you are saying yourself, oh, I can't come out like this to testify. That's what you are saying to yourself. So that nobody will laugh at you. So, and it will be difficult for that person to come out and testify. You can see what happened. This is what happened. Immediately after the spirit left her, we asked her, where is the typhoid? Disappear. Where is the headache? Disappear. Where is the body weight? Disappear. The skin came back. So, you that you are in this kind of church, that you are still going back to where you are coming from, after God has healed you, because you don't want to testify. Some people, you pray for them. When you say come and testify, they will not come, because you don't want to come and testify. That doing yourself. This is a place where you be, you are free from Satan. Many of your problems are Satan. You can see, when he sleeps, somebody will be collecting money from her in her dream.
that person collecting money is the person we cast out. He run down our business. He was running down our health. The next thing to do, according to him, what he say, see, I want to kill her. Many people you see dying. That boy that died yesterday, I don't know whether his sister or the mother is here. It's Satan that kill him. It's not the will of God. You will not be in a good church where your life is guaranteed. You will be going around.